Good morning.
Good morning.
58 years ago, on February 1st, 1960, four African-American college students from North Carolina A&T State University in Greensboro, North Carolina, stunned the world by a simple act. Franklin McCain, Joseph McNeil, Giselle Blair, and David Richmond sat down at a whites-only lunch counter at the local Woolworth store. The young black man politely asked for coffee when told they would not be served. The student sat peacefully until the store closed. This quiet act of rebellion sparked many sit-ins across the South to end racial segregation. It was a spark that spread like wildfire across North Carolina. From February the 1st until July 25th, 1960, the Greensboro Four, as they became known, staged a series of sit-ins. They were joined by tens of thousands of students, both black and white, even people in the North, where Woolworth's lunch counters were not segregated, wanted to support the movement. On July 25th, 1960, the Woolworth store lunch counter in Greensboro was finally integrated. People of all races could sit together and eat, but it would take a few more years for every business in Greensboro to take down the whites-only sign for good. Today, you can see parts of the lunch counter in museums in Greensboro and at museums in Washington, D.C. On the campus of NC-A&T State University in Greensboro, N.C., a 15-foot bronze and marble monument dedicated on February the 1st, 2002 to honor the four students who are known to the world as Greensboro Four. The Greensboro Four sat down not just for themselves. They wanted to create a better world for everybody. Their acts of courage still inspire us today.